and don't skip.
Oh, that's right.
And make sure you leave a like on this video.
Mm-hmm. And subscribe.
Yep. Make sure Gigi gets more followers.
That's right. Welcome back to a What's for Dinner video. What do you eat when your kitchen is in the middle of a remodel? I'm going to show you in this video. Here are some clips for the past couple of months as I've been able to get the camera out and film. I haven't been doing that very often. But let's just look at this first one here. This obviously steaks. James grilled those up. In my air fryer, I just sliced some Yukon Gold potatoes in half, rubbed them with a little bit of olive oil, put a little salt on them, and I just did those in my air fryer. And I like doing those in the oven as well. I think I've probably showed those. So that's just a delicious potato side dish that's quick, and then a salad. So this is an easy meal to have during a remodel because grill, air fryer, salad. Didn't take any cooking for that. So that is what we had on this night.
All right, tonight for dinner, we are having barbecue beef quesadillas. So I made a big crock pot of barbecue beef yesterday. Just basically beef roast and shred that all up. I mixed in a little bit of ground beef with it and put our barbecue sauce on it. And then so for leftovers tonight, I just put it in a low-carb tortilla, fried it up, made a little quesadilla, got some green Tabasco sour cream and some taco flavored Doritos. Very quick, gonna be delicious. I'm frying up some pork chops tonight in my skillet. I just have some olive oil heating up, and then I just have some flour here. And my pork chops, I'm gonna go in with some black pepper. I'm gonna use a little bit of garlic salt, and that is just about it. I'm gonna season this, flour it real well. I'm gonna fry it on a little bit high, just to get a good sear on it, good crust going. I'll turn it down and let it cook low and slow.
Hey, can I be an outside
video? Yeah, what do you want to say?
I just want to say that I really like this video. Hi, guys. Well, I love you, and I want to get and watch all the way to the end and don't skip.
Oh, that's right.
And make sure you leave a like on this video.
Mm-hmm. And subscribe.
Yep. Make sure Gigi gets more followers.
That's right. Say, see you later, guys.
See you later, guys. Bye.
All right, here's my pork chops. I've said this before when I'm frying things, so I'm going to say it again because it bears repeating. I have my hot oil in my skillet. I make sure and fry both sides and get a good crust on there. Then when my oil looks like it's just about gone and everything is seared up, got a good crust on it, I put a little bit of water in the bottom of my skillet. You put a lid on it, you can do that as well. Basically what happens, this just kind of helps to continue to cook the meat without really browning it any further. And it kind of steams it in a way to where it's tender, more tender by doing this process. And then I just try not to mess with it too much because I don't want the crust that I have on there to come off. So I will just let this water continue cooking on down. I'll check the temperature of the meat, or I'll just judge by how it looks, because I can pretty well do that with pork chops because I've cooked them for years and years. I kind of know. But that, I think, is the key to getting a really tender and juicy piece of meat without overcooking it. All right, and here's my plate. There's my fried pork chop. Have some Yukon Gold mashed potatoes and some green beans. That's what's for dinner tonight. All right, remember I told you guys we were in the middle of a kitchen remodel. My kitchen is basically gutted, with the exception of my stove, refrigerator, and one little section of cabinets. We haven't torn that out yet while we're doing some of the other work. So another quick and easy dinner. I'm using this Pepperidge Farms farmhouse bread in the lemon poppy seed flavor, and I am making some French toast. So there's my egg mixture with a little bit of evaporated milk. This is the bread I'm going to use. My turkey bacon's frying, and I'll probably make some eggs to go along with it, and I'll show you when we're all done here. Cheesy scrambled eggs and turkey bacon, and I have not plated up my French toast yet. I already made James plate, and I'm getting ready to plate up my French toast, and I'll use this Kirkland maple syrup, and this is going to be our delicious breakfast for dinner tonight in our extremely partial kitchen. Everybody, here is tonight's dinner. We are in the middle of a kitchen remodel, so everything is a little bit out of normal, out of our routine. So that's okay. We're just making do with what meals we can get together quick with the lack of a fully functioning kitchen. So this is a meatball sub. I made meatballs yesterday, just the bagged frozen Italian meatballs in marinara sauce. Put the meatballs in the pan, poured over the jarred marinara, and baked it for about a half an hour. And then this is what we had left over, enough to make two sandwiches. I had these little hoagie rolls from the deli in my freezer. I just put some mayonnaise on both sides, some shredded mozzarella, some Parmesan on this side, and then just made a side salad. And so this has romaine. It's got some green pepper and onion and shredded carrot, some cherry tomato and cheese, and then it is the Mediterranean style Greek dressing from Aldi. And so this is James. Mine looks pretty much the same, only I have ranch dressing. And that is our real quick and easy dinner for tonight.
Tonight's dinner during kitchen remodel. So it's a lot of pantry, freezer, easy cooking things that I don't have to get to a lot of ingredients or utensils or so on and so forth. So under here is the Aldi red bag frozen southern style like chicken breast. Just baked those. On top is some white gravy. It's just a Pioneer brand from the envelope. You just mix it with water and it makes a really good kind of white gravy that you would put over like chicken fried steak, country fried steak. Homemade macaroni and cheese. Just boiled up the noodles and used some butter and some Velveeta. And then just a box of stovetop stuffing. So that's our quick and easy dinner for tonight. Kind of went the comfort food route. All right, we started this video with steak and we're gonna end it with steak. James did a couple more steaks on the grill. We have a freezer full of beef. Plus James loves steak. I do too. I decided to do a Knorr, I think it's just urban butter rice packet. And I just cut my steak up and put on there and then put some cheese on the top. For some reason, this just sounded good for me this evening. And it was. The grill is working out great while we are working around here. So that's all I've got for you guys today. I will have another video next week. I do have some more things that I've been filming. And so I hope you come back to see what we continue to eat during this time when our kitchen is not normal. So come on back. Give this video a like, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you the next time. Bye-bye.